Hello and welcome to eCraft. In this video, we will demonstrate the initial step for setting up wireless remote joystick control. This can be applied to a range of applications such as a robotic cart, an RC plane, a drone, or any similar device. We are utilizing a joystick shield with Arduino UNO clone. The joystick incorporates two potentiometers to indicate its position in two axes. The potentiometer's wiper, which indicates the position on the x-axis, is connected to the A0 input of the Arduino UNO clone. Similarly, the wiper of the Y-axis potentiometer is connected to the A1 input of the Arduino UNO clone when this shield is installed. Apart from the joystick, there are several push buttons. Additionally, there is a connector to install an NRF24L012.4 GHz radio transceiver module that can be interfaced with the Arduino UNO, on which the shield is installed. These are the components used for the radio joystick control: the joystick shield, an Arduino UNO, and an NRF24L01 radio module with a power amplifier and low noise amplifier. The RF Nano board is an Arduino Nano and NRF24L01 module combined, which is used as the receiver. The video uses RF Nano board version 1.1, with 8MHz 328P microcontroller and NRF24L01 transceiver connected to the SPI signals. The Arduino UNO is connected to an NRF24L01 module with an integrated PA and LNA via the joystick shield. We are using an Arduino UNO clone in this video. This radio module has an SMA connector to which an antenna is connected. This module can have a maximum 1 km range. Note that when the joystick lever is pressed, a push button input is also activated. This input is a digital input connected to I/O pin D8 of the Arduino UNO clone board. Let's first understand how to read the joystick position data using the analog read function before diving into the functionality of the NRF24L01 radio transceiver module. As previously mentioned, the X-axis potentiometer input is connected to pin A0 of the Arduino UNO, while the Y-axis input is connected to A1. Here is a snapshot of the joystick shield card schematic diagram that displays the connections between the joystick and the Arduino UNO. In this sketch, we have defined two integer variables to store the readings of the X and Y-axis. We use the function analogRead to retrieve the position data of the joystick axis. This function returns a 10-bit analog value ranging from 0 to 1023, which we then print on the serial port. When the joystick is in the middle position, the reading should ideally be 512 since the potentiometer wiper is at the center of the resistor. Let's examine the values here. The x-axis shows either 503 or 504, while the y-axis hovers around 499. This variation could be due to the potentiometer and ADC accuracy. I will now move the stick. Firstly, I will move along the y-axis, so you can see the second value change. Next, I will move the joystick along the x-axis. Observe the first value as it changes. The joystick is working correctly. Next, we will wirelessly transmit the joystick information to the receiver RF Nano board. The first step would be to develop a simple pair of sketches, one each for the joystick remoter controller or the transmitter and the RF Nano boards as the receiver. Both devices are connected to separate COM ports to verify sent and receive data equality. It is worth noting that the RF Nano board has the ability to transmit signals. On the other hand, the Arduino UNO board, equipped with the joystick shield and the NRF24L01 radio module, is capable of receiving the transmitted signal. Typically, in a remote control application, the command is sent in one direction only. Occasionally, the controller may require an acknowledgement in return. However, for the sake of simplicity, we will begin with a basic application. Using the library to work with the NRF24L01 and Arduino is more convenient. The library shown here has already been installed. Let's review the sketch for the transmitter. First, the libraries are instantiated. As the transmitter will be sending two integer values corresponding to the X and Y axis positions, an integer array of two variables is declared. The radio module is connected to the SPI bus of the Arduino Uno. The chip enable signal of the RF module has been wired to the D9 pin of the Arduino Uno, while the SPI chip select is linked to the D10 pin. It is crucial to identify the port pins that the CE and CSN signals are connected to. Inside the setup function, the radio module is initialized. It is worth noting that the default SPI communication speed is set to 1 MHz, but it can be changed wherever applicable. Next, the communication channel with the given address is opened for write operation, also known as a pipe. It is important to use the same address for the receiver module as well. In the loop function, we are reading the positions of the potentiometer axes on the analog input pins A0 and A1. These values are then stored in an integer array of size 2. Additionally, the values are printed on the serial port and written to the NRF24L01 radio module on the SPI bus. Let's review the receiver code that will run in the RF Nano board. The same libraries are used here as well. I made some changes to the values for the CE and the CSN pins, as they are different. My RF Nano version 1.1 has the CE pin connected to the port pin D10 of the controller, while the CSN pin is connected to the port pin D9. If you're using a different version of the board, you should check these connections. For instance, version 3.0 of the board has these two pins connected to the controller port pin 7 and 8 respectively. The rest of the code is pretty much the same except for a few places. In this sketch, a red pipe is opened with the same address. The data received by the receiver module is saved in an array of two integers and printed on the serial port. We will upload the transmitter sketch to the Arduino Uno with the joystick shield and download the receiver sketch into the RF Nano board. The sketches have been uploaded successfully. The window on the left-hand side displays the position data of the joystick axes that are being sent to the receiver. On the right-hand side window, we can see the data received wirelessly. You can observe the changes in the data as the joystick is moved. In the next video, we will control a couple of motors using the RF Nano and the wireless joystick remote control. Thanks for watching.